In this tutorial, I'll show you how to model and render snail characters. I'll post a link to this tutorial's reference image in the description below. Create a cube and scale it. Create a loop cut with Ctrl R and increase the number of cuts to 25. Press Ctrl 3 to subdivide. Use the proportional editing to scale the mesh like this. Create an eye mesh by using a UV sphere. Duplicate the eye mesh to create an iris mesh by selecting the middle edge loop and proportionally moving it backward. We can create the mouth by using a subdivided cube. Create an antenna mesh by extruding a subdivided plane. Please ignore the purple cube you see on the left. I tried to use that cube with array and curve modifier, but that didn't work. Create a curve point, and press the 3D button. Turn off the normal indicator. If you don't see the curve point, please activate an add-on called Add Curve, Extra Objects. Extrude the curve point. Press A to select all and press V and A to make the curve smooth. Bevel the curve. Select a curve point and press Alt S to resize. Select this edge loop with Alt Select, press Ctrl E, and select Mark Seam. Select this edge with Alt Select and Mark Seam as well. Let's unwrap the mesh. Export the UV layout and open it in Photoshop. Here's an example UV image map that I have created in Photoshop. This is what we need to do. We need 3 layers in total, and the top layer needs to have the UV layout. The bottom layer will have a background color and the mid layer will contain the yellow stripes. Draw like this to create a pattern and save the image with the first layer hidden. Open the image in Blender and please remember to select the BSDF node and press Ctrl T to add the image texture node like mine. If Ctrl T doesn't work for you, please activate an add-on called Node Wrangler. Let's create an armature for the body mesh and pose it. When a visible oddness appears on the mesh like that, please double check to see if the armature modifier is at the top of the modifiers stack. Let's create the base mesh like this. Now we can finalize the snail mesh. The second snail can be created by duplicating and mirroring on the x-axis. Let's change the material and work on the details. Let's create a UV sphere. Duplicate the sphere with Shift D and place it like this while scaling. Create a ground plane and turn it into a light bouncing wall. Please watch a tutorial listed in the description to match my final render settings, as I'm using a cloned look dev HDRI setting. This is the end of the snail characters tutorial. Please like and subscribe if you have enjoyed watching this tutorial. Thank you for watching.